Hello everyone, my name is Dianine and today we talk about the Witches Festival for the Elder Scrolls Online. As always, you can find timestamps in the video description. The Witches Festival got introduced 2016 and usually returns mid of October. The festival is part of the base game and you don't need special DLCs or ESO Plus to earn unique rewards or event tickets. If you never participated in the past in the Witches Festival, you have to complete the quest Witchmother's Bargain. Open the crown store and use the free quest starter crown caller to summon the Witchmother and start the quest. She will request you to obtain a pumpkin, a sample of guts and a sense of death. The quickest way to obtain pumpkin and guts is to look at the guild traders and buy them with gold. If you don't want to spend gold, you can find guts by looting small animals and fleshly undeads. And pumpkins can be found in containers or on the ground throughout Tamriel. Or you can purchase them from NPC crossers for 150 gold. To obtain the sense of death, you must kill the boss of any delve. Delves in Cyrodiil are not working to earn a sense of death. Once you have all three ingredients, you will be directed to the Witchmother's Brewery in Auridon, Clenumbra or Stormfalls. You may use any of these three locations, regardless of your alliance. Even so, the quest will still direct you to the alliance's zone. After you deliver the requested items to the Witchmother, she will start to prepare her brew. Complete the quest, the Witchmother's Bargain, to receive the Witchmother's Whistle Memento. Use the Witchmother's Whistle Memento to summon the Witchmother's Cauldron. This will grant you and your party a 2-hour 100% XP buff that stacks with all other XP bonuses. You can't use the memento in Cyrodiil, but you can activate the buff before you enter Cyrodiil to use the double XP buff there too. You don't have to drink from the Witchmother's Cauldron in order to gain the XP buff, but if you decide to taste the Witchmother's brew, you will transform into a skeleton for a limited time. If you completed a quest in previous events, you don't need to acquire the Crow Caller or complete the quest again. You can use the whistle already found in your collections menu. During the event, all boss monsters will drop unique Plunder Skulls and Remora Plunder Skulls, which will contain amazing Witches Festival themed loot. Plunder Skull containers have a chance to contain the following spooky items: Holojack motif pages or books, pieces of the Apple Bobbing Cauldron Memento, a rune box containing a pumpkin spectre mask, or a scarecrow spectre mask, or a Holojack spectre mask, or a Thicketman spectre mask. Many Witches Festival themed recipes, furniture and furniture recipes, Holojack and Remora style crafting materials, and some alchemy ingredients. The past years there was a hidden 3-minute timer for Plunder Skulls. I'm not sure if that will be this year the case too, but in case you don't get any Plunder Skulls, maybe try to slow down a bit so you have at least 3 minutes between each boss fight. On PC, some people also published add-ons to track your Plunder Skulls and Remora Skulls, but I'm not sure if they are still supported and working. Last year, ESO added the Remora Plunder Skulls, which you can acquire additionally to the regular Plunder Skulls. These will be the first Plunder Skull drop you receive for each type of boss each day. The Remora Plunder Skull contains all the same items found in the regular Plunder Skull, but it also includes a Remora motif page based on the type of boss you defeated. The final boss of the Dragonstar or Maestro Marena dropped Remora motif pages for bows and legs. Dark Anchor and Geysir bosses dropped Remora motif pages for daggers and gloves. Delve bosses dropped Remora motif pages for staves and belts. The final boss of a group dungeon dropped Remora motif pages for helm and maces. Public dungeon and quest bosses dropped Remora motif pages for shields and boots. Final tribe bosses dropped Remora motif pages for swords and chests. World bosses dropped Remora motif pages for shoulder and axe. You can also find Witches Festival writs within Remora Plunder Skulls. Each Remora Plunder Skull has a chance to provide one of these crafting writs. To complete the Witches Festival writs, you need to craft food or drinks from the recipes found in Plunder Skulls, or a particular potion based on alchemy ingredients found in Plunder Skulls. These writs work much like Master writs. They can be traded, mailed and sold. Once you accept the contract, however, they are bound to you. If you complete 13 Witches Festival writs, you will earn the Witch's Infernal Head. And for completing 18 Witches Festival writs, you will earn the title Witch. Remora Plunder Skulls now also include a chance to obtain Glimmoril Armor Outfit styles. The specific Remora Plunder Skull does not matter, any Dremora Plunderskull could contain any Glenmoral armor outfit style. Glenmoral wood weapons can be found with the help of Glenmoral treasure maps. During the Witch's Festival, you have a chance to find in Dremora Plunderskull's Glenmoral treasure maps. These treasure maps lead you to locations throughout Tamriel. At your destination, you will find a Glenmoral weapon. Each treasure map leads to a specific weapon, but the treasure map you obtain from a Dremora Plunderskull is random. You can also find in-depth showcases of the Holojack, Dremora and Glenmoral style on my channel, and I will link them in the video description. This year, ESO added also a new memento, the Skeletal Marionette Memento. You need to collect 10 skeleton marionette parts, which can occasionally be obtained from any type of plunder or Dremora skull. During the Witch's Festival, you have also the opportunity to purchase a unique house. The Exercise Coven Cottage will be purchasable via the Crown Store, but also with gold during the Witch's Festival if you have the Witch's Festival achievement and Unsparing Harvest unlocked. This spooky and cozy little cottage is located in Glenumbra and is only available during the Witch's Festival. If you completed all achievements related to the Witch's Festival, you can unlock the Sunstar Creeper title. You can also earn event tickets during the Witch's Festival. You will earn 2 event tickets per day when you acquire your first Dremora Plunderskull. At least it was the case the last year. I usually just completed a dolmen or defeated a delve boss to obtain easily my daily event tickets. Since the last quarter of the year is already starting with the Witch's Festival, I assume that we will be able to obtain our first Intrigue Berry for the pure white Intrigue. Thanks for watching, and it would be wonderful if you subscribe, like or leave me a comment. Have a nice day, and until next time, tschüss!